I would like to take the floor and roll it over to Snoqualmie, and I understand Snohomish is standing with Snoqualmie. You have the floor.
Well, good evening, Tribal Journey. Are you having a good one? We sure did. Dida Halkade Tidsta. My name is Dida Halkade. O Ululus Chatatasbakwa. I travel in the blue heron canoe. Stahobschud. I am Snohomish. Stahobschud. And this year, we also traveled with the Snoqualmie. We traveled together. We traveled as one. We mixed our camps. We shared meals together. We camped in the same spot. We traveled the same route. And I thought it fitting that we also come together during protocol. So that's what you see here is actually two groups, two canoes. One is the Blue Heron, and the other one is the Northern Dipper. Northern Dipper is Snoqualmie. You guys know about the Blue Heron? Well, some of you do. So some of you don't. So I'll tell you a little bit about it. It came to life in the spring of 2003, and we've had it on tribal journeys ever since then. This year we traveled from Celilo Village on the Columbia River, and that was pretty special. So it was so special that we got 15 to 25 mile an hour winds gusting to 40, and wind waves probably up to 4 feet, you know, stuff like that. That was pretty special. So that day we didn't do much traveling at, by the way. So it came to life in the spring of 2003, and before that I was skippering other canoes and paddling. So I started in about 95 on the first half of the full circle journey. So I'm going to have the Snoqualmie people come up and tell me a little bit about their history, about the canoe family history. You want us to tell us a little bit about your canoe and about your family?
Okay. It was built by my cousins, Wayne and Jacob, named Northern Dipper after my grandpa Earl Moses. We come out every year and just paddle hard and try to make it to our destination safe and sound. So that's all I got to say about our canoe.
So we started at Celilo Village and we come down the Columbia River. Warm Springs and Cowlitz joined us. They left at Fort Vancouver. They're in Portland, and so we were on our own for a couple of days, just the two of us, the two canoe families, that is. And then later we were joined by the Chinook people down at Skamoka Way, and followed them down to the mouth of the Columbia River, portaged over into Willapa Bay, and then traveled out there on the ocean for a day or two up to Westport and into Grace Harbor. So that's kind of the same route we're probably going to take next year, but we probably want to do more of it all together sorts of things and end up in Tohola. So that's a couple of days out there on the ocean, which is a little bit different than the river. The river's got all sorts of different challenges. I got a little story that I want to tell the Squaxin people. So I have a language teacher. You guys probably all know him as Uswali Zomai Zaire. And he's down in Eugene, Oregon getting his doctorate, but there's some people around here that know who I'm talking about. So he managed to get one of the Squaxin elders and take her out to Squaxin Island. So when they went out there, she was showing us where she was raised, there on Squaxin Island. And they have no water out there, she was telling us. And so they had to bring water in from a nearby island. They had no electricity and all sorts of crazy things she was telling us. She climbed up the bank and into her old apple orchard. Nellie Ramirez was her name. And there's a couple things about Nellie that I want to relate to you because I think they're good little stories. The first one was that she was mad. She was mad about being taken away from Squaxin and marrying this guy that took her to Tohola. And he was long gone, but she was still very mad. And she was telling us about every 30 minutes, she was telling us how mad she was at him for taking her away. So that was one of the things that I remember about Nellie. The other thing is that she was telling us that when she was young, she would tree a squirrel in a little sapling. So she chased this little squirrel into the sapling. Then she took that sapling and with both her hands would twirl it in a circle. She would twirl it long enough that that squirrel would get dizzy. The squirrel would pass out, fall to the ground, and she'd pick it up and pet it like a cat or something. But that was one of the stories that she had, and I remember her climbing up the bank and sitting there in her place where she'd lived for many years telling us these stories. So she's very special, and I wanted all the people here to hear that little special little story. So thank you for one of your elders. She's gone now on the other side, but her memory still of her still lingers with me. So thank you for all that. And by the way, the second year of Full Circle Journey, the journey ended in Squaxin. So this is actually the second journey. The first one was a lot different than this one. There was only like 12 canoes. That was it. And it was at Priest Point. Yeah, it was pretty tiny. Keep going. He's going to switch out microphones.
He'll sound a little bit different.
Do I sound any different? Tall, good looking, handsome, rich and famous, and none of the above, right? Somebody told me that I was pretty once. Pretty in at least two ways. Oh, you're laughing. You've heard this before. You say that I was pretty in two ways. Pretty ugly and pretty likely to stay that way. Okay, I guess we want to sing a song for you now. Enough of this talking stuff. We want to sing. And the Snoqualmies have one called Honor Elder Song. You guys ready for that one?
We would also like to ask for you to stand and remove any hats that aren't regalia or don't have an eagle feather in them. This is the Honor Elder Song. This song was gifted back to Snoqualmie from Peg Dean and the Suquamish Dance Troupe in 2000 at the Snoqualmie Re-Recognization Ceremony.
So some of these have been in the canoe. They know about the waves being over their heads. We've crossed the Strait of Juan de Fuca with ground swells and wind waves and all that. And so that's what they're doing. They're pointing to the tops of the waves and tracing them, and then having to dig deep and hard. Some of them have been there. They know that. So even though they're young, I still take them on the canoe, and we have a wonderful time out there. So not all of them, just the one with the blue vests on.
Traditional Snoqualmie song, and the song carrier is Ray Mullen.
Hey!
I think this, there it is. So since we got some of you out on the floor, we want to do another one. This one is a little for the younger people especially. So if there's any young people out there, pay attention because we're going to do something special with you for that. We call it Bear. And it belongs to my son, Ben Evans. And I'll tell you a little bit more about it later. He's the one that likes to sleep with his rump in the air. So that's a, I guess you call that a rump up. This is Bear Song. The words of this song are Aswalachwab ti schatwad. The bear is strong. Aswalachwab ti schatwad. Yeah, go ahead and enter. And then a circle in the middle. Go ahead and enter. Dancers, singers, you ready? Okay, that's the end of that one. That was a demonstration. Now I want my dancers to go get somebody, grab their hand, and bring them back with you. So my son has given this for public domain, which means that if you learn it and you like it, it's yours to practice, okay? So that's why I said there was something special. Pay attention, because you're gonna probably get to do it again. Dancers, ready? Thank you. seen it demonstrated, right? Now anybody else wants to join can. So anybody from the audience want to come and do this one, want to learn it? This will be round number three. All you young people, young at heart, come on down to the floor. If you see somebody that you think might want, just go out there and grab their hand, make them dance with you. Is any of the canoe families that were with us on the journey, Warm Springs, yep, Cowlitz, you guys should be out here, right? Chinook, they know this one as well. So round number three. Dancers, are you ready? Thank you for dancing with us. Woo! Okay, did that liven things up a little bit? We were going to do the host giveaway, but I think there's one last song. They twisted my arm. Ouch. And we want to sing a song for you, one last song. And is there a dance with this, Cheyenne? Just a song. Is it just a song, or is it you want to do the dance too? OEO. Yeah. So she says yes, a paddle song. Okay. So she can. They can come out on the. They all disappeared. Where'd they go? How many were there? Which way did they go? I got to catch up to them. I'm their leader. They went to go get the paddles so they can sing the paddle song. And so I can introduce this. There's sometimes that you're laying around, let's say it's late at night on the sofa, and you're watching movies like Turner Classic Movies, and one of these old ones come on. Starts off in black and white and turns to color. You know, a young lady that gets lost, you know. And she's found, and she goes through the witch's castle. And I woke up about that time, and they were singing a song I thought would make a great paddle song. O-E-O. That's it. You guys know it. Oh.
dipped in milk. All right. I guess it's okay to plagiarize from them occasionally, so yeah, I guess that's an okay one. That one we also consider public domain, so if you guys want to use that, you can. Ready for the gifts? You want to have them brought out? Okay. So I know that it takes a lot of planning. It takes a lot of work, a lot of coordination. It takes a pretty big team to make this happen. And I know that that you guys are just the heads. You're here to make sure it works, make sure that it goes off well. So we really appreciate it. And was it really $4 million? Wow. So that's what I'm saying. This is wow. How about a big hand for them? So I'm kind of buying another minute or time before the gifts come out. Somebody said tell a joke. Oh, you guys probably know I like jokes. So you can tell me one of these days, okay? We're in the canoe, and I had a captive audience in the canoe. And there was another canoe a little ways off, and a third canoe a little ways off. So I shouts over to the second canoe, how do you keep a turkey in suspense? And of course the waves are roaring and he shouts back, I don't know how. So I said it again, how do you keep a turkey in suspense? And then somebody told him he was the turkey. He went like that, okay. Okay, it's a bad joke, right? So when they're in the canoe, I tell bad jokes, and if they don't like my jokes, they continue to paddle them. It's a form of torture. We really appreciate that you have your elders here, the leaders, the elders, your council, all of those people, and we think they're very important. And they help keep us on the right path. They keep us safe. They keep us doing all the things that we're supposed to be doing. And then the young people, they get to provide all the energy. So I think that's really pretty special that you guys have those elders. And we do want to recognize that. We're a pretty small group. There was times I only had three polars in the canoe. There was one time, yeah, I gave them up to... the other three polars I had, I gave them up to the other canoe because they were lagging behind. That was after 27 miles, nor was it 37. I think it was closer to 37 miles. Going down the Columbia River, it's a little easier because you got to push with you. So 37 miles is not as bad. So we were hitting 37 miles. The other canoe was behind us. I gave up all my polars. I have only myself and two other in the canoe, and we're still ahead of them. Yeah, it was one of those days. So they have some gifts for the elders here. An elder man, because we don't have a lot, but we do have things that we want to give. So if there was a representative of your elders, an elder man, male, just stand up, and hopefully we'll be able to bring the gift to you, because I think that's the right thing to do, is... not cause you any more work, we'll do the work. And I believe that there's a blanket from Snoqualmie. A blanket from Snoqualmie. I don't see the blankets out there. And I traveled with them 37 miles. have a representative from your elders, female? So my lady over here, yep. Just stand right there and we'll come to you. How about that? All right. How about a representative from your chiefs and council? I guess it's council that I'm concerned about. Council, either your chairperson or somebody else representing your council. So we have a blanket for you as well. They do have a blanket, but it was from the wrong family. And besides a blanket, they were talking about a little basket from the Snoqualmies. And I think that's the basket. So the Blue Heron Canoe family doesn't have a tribe backing them, so it comes out of our pocket. So we want you to understand that it is from us, it is from the heart, and this is what we want to do. So we got a blanket ready for you in the box. Is there a like a hereditary chief that's represented here? You don't have a hereditary chief here today. Do you have somebody that can represent them? Take a gift on their behalf? You don't have anybody? Would you see that it gets to one of them? David George Christ? All right. Aetziab. Thank you for all your work, all that weight of responsibility. We thank you for that. And now there's something about a youth boy in the bag, backpack. A youth boy. Is there somebody from Squaxin that can represent that? I'm sure you got some youth in here someplace. This one here? How are you? You want to hand that to him? All right. Youth female. You have a youth female? Youth female. Coming. There she is. All right. We have a little token, a little gift from us to you. Very good. Thank you. Stop. Wait. Slow down a minute. Necklace. All right. Now we also have a one for a very young female, very young, smaller, real tiny, year too old. Somebody like that? You don't have anybody like that? Somebody who's pregnant? That's a little baby, you know, this little one. Somebody that could send one to one of those people. A real young one. Somebody? You're nodding your head. You have one? He's over there. He's right there. Just said that. So that little doll is one that we made. So she's representing that as well. So So we know that we've been traveling with some of your skippers and on the water. There's a couple of them, Davy George Grice, Jeremiah George, and I met the other one. I met him several times, but his name leaves me right at the moment. A representative from your skippers. Jeremiah George, okay? Now, if you can get a canoe this long in reality. You got somebody from your ground crew? They're pretty important too. They help move everything, get it there safely. Your ground crew is pretty special. Some places they call them ground squirrels. So, the ground crew, are you that too? Wow, you can do everything, right? We also know that some of that responsibility falls on the coordinators. Those are the leaders, your little teams. Again? How many hats does that make? More than you can count on one hand? Somebody once said that those responsibilities are like juggling balls. You know, you can juggle one pretty good. Two, some people can. Three gets a little bit harder. By the time you get to four and five, it takes a really special person. So I think we have a blanket from the Blue Heron Canoe and a basket. Your hands are going to be full. So the planning, I guess, on this started several years ago. And I'm going to guess that they have been working this entire time to make this thing happen, to come off the way it did. So a representative from your planning staff. They're still at work. Yes, okay. We'll deliver it to them. Okay, a blanket from the Blue Heron and a basket from Snoqualmie. Be sure you bring the box with them. The box goes with it, with the blanket. Blanket. How about, all right, thank you very much. How about, you want to stay up here? We want to get another blanket? Yeah, he says yeah. Your banquet staff, the cook staff, the people that handled the food, we want to do something special to them. They did something special for us, and we want you to know that we did this. So a blanket from the Blue Heron. Something about some coffee, and from Snoqualmie, some necklaces. And we want to recognize the guys are on the floor that are working really hard late at night. We got a little token for them as well.
More coffee.
Okay, I got it. More coffee. So there was a little token from the Snoqualmie mini drums. And what are those? Coffee, regular, double shot, tall, even decaf might work. Thank you again for all that work you've been doing on the floor. Thank you very much. Okay, so on Swalasa's behalf, Ray Christ wanted to let you all know that his father, John Christ, is doing well and he's back, and it's still bothering him a little bit. So, we want to, all those well wishes that you guys gave is paying off. Thank you.
Gualapo, Gualapo Tirishin, a squirted of chest, Paul Squash said. A squirted of chest, Paul Tislahil, a squirted of chest, Paul Tigwadzadad, a tea yot yalab. A squirted of chest, Paul Tist Elib. A squirted of chest. His claws last little light. His shaba stout hopes. No, my sister.
Good evening, my brothers and sisters. We are greatly honored to be here. For our paddlers, it was a long journey, and we are very, very thankful that they made it safe here. They traveled a long distance. In 1989, when they had the first paddle to Seattle, our relatives, the Duwamish, we were standing there. Cecile was a chairman, and we were greeting the canoes as they come in, and we looked at each other and we said, you know, here we are welcoming all the other paddlers from all the other tribes, and we didn't have a canoe at that time. And we cried and cried, and we said, you know, someday the Snoqualmies and Duwamish will have a canoe. We have very fine wood carvers, and I'm proud to say that now we have been making the journey. My heart is so filled with love for each and every one of you. It's been a long time coming for our people. We received recognition in 1999. Took 142 years to finally get our recognition. I have been trying to follow in our ancestors' ways to teach the young people. And they are learning. And I always tell them, be proud of where you come from. You're going to be carrying on someday when we are called away. I've been honored to be on the Tribal Council 48 years. There has been some sorrow in our tribe. My sister Margaret Mullen, that was here watching protocol, had a heart attack. We did a prayer circle for her last night, and praise the Lord, she's coming home. She's coming home to us. I'd like to sing a song that was taught to me by my mother. She learned it from her grandmother, Shasha Blue. She was a medicine woman who lived to be 124. In our nation, when a baby is born, they are given a walking stick. A notch is put in for every year. That's how they had their calendars. And after many, many years, they're going to bring that walking stick back to us that someone had taken. So that's a little history of our tribe. I'd like to sing this honor song for you. Please, if you would stand, and the drummers follow me.
Tell me about it.
Good evening. My name is Arlene Ventura. I'd like to acknowledge a tribal member, a council chairperson, or someone from the Suquamish tribe. There were two guests that were allowed to go on the journey with them. That was Ray Mullen and myself. We were given permission to travel with them. And I think we owe them, and we have to honor them, because this is how we got started. And I know that our group, Snoqualmie Tribe and the Canoe Family, they continually to do their fundraising. every year in order to be able to participate on the canoe journey. But I want to give a thanks to the Snoqualmie tribe, because this is how we got started. And it's a trip that I will never forget. It was my first time, and I was a ground squirrel. I enjoyed every bit of it. It was hard work, taking down tents, putting up tents, and cooking at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, making sandwiches or whatever. But it was my first trip, and I'll never forget it. I got hooked. And so I'd like to honor with a blanket. Thank you very much.
Are you ready for some more singing? I think so. I am.
This next song is the Deer Transformer. It is a traditional Snoqualmie song, and the song carrier is Ray Mullen.
This next song we want to sing is a slow battle dance. And it was first sung at my mother's funeral, so it could be used for some other things as well. But so for me, it was pretty special. And we want to sing that for you. This was composed by Art Duran, Nanook, and I guess it's considered public domain. That's what he said. So it's public domain. Whoa.
got another song by the Snoqualmie, and they call this Allah.
Allah. Allah. This is the Allah song. It's carried by the Canaan family. We have been given permission by them to sing it, and it's about their grandmother basket weaving.
Oh.
as they scurry around the back to get some more stuff. We want to honor those who are still with us, those in the audience, and all of those people. So we have some general giveaway sorts of things. To that, we also want to be sure that some of your workers also have some of those gifts, because they're not here, they're out there working. So we have a little cash, a few things, that you can give to them as well. Okay. Anybody know a good joke? Number 23. That, you got to hear the rest of that, though. So I've told them so many times over and over again in the canoe, I've got them numbered now. So all I have to do is shout out a number like 23, and they all start laughing. And then the new person, he tries it. He says, 23. Nobody laughed. Afterwards, he came up to me and said, how come when you said a number, everybody laughed, and when I said a number, nobody laughed? And I turned to him and I said, it's because you didn't tell it right.
You got a good one.
Yeah.
Speaking of numbers, this fellow was walking down the sidewalk, and there's a big long fence, and there's all these people chanting 12, 12, 12, and he's like, what's going on over here? And he walks down the fence, and he sees a hole, a knot hole. So he goes and he pokes his eye in there, and boom, he gets poked in the eye, and everyone starts chanting 13, 13.
I've heard that before, though. They did not see that coming. Who said that? I heard that there were three types of people: those who can count and those who can't. If you didn't get that, there's a problem, right? Four out of three people have problems with fractions. Yes, that's what I've been waiting for. So I told him to pass out, and one of them fainted. That's not what I meant. I meant pass out all the gifts that we got going. You guys heard about Mahatma Gandhi? That was a mystic seer from India. That was a seer. And he had a habit that wherever he went, he would walk. So he had on his feet, he had lots and lots of calluses, a super amount of calluses on his feet. And because of his diet, he also was very frail. He had a frail body. And then one of the side effects of having a frail body is that he had halitosis. And halitosis is a form of bad breath. So you're ready for this joke? You ready for the punchline? He was a super callous, fragile mystic, hex with halitosis. Can you repeat that one? So please give out your gifts for I tend to get to the end of all of my jokes.
He seems to like telling jokes, so I'll squeeze another one in here. There was a set of twins that was born, and they were adopted out. And many, many, many years later, the mother went to go on a search, and they were separated. She found out they were separated. One was named Imal, lived way on the other side of the country. And one just lived right down the street, and his name was Juan. And so she drove down there and visited him and tried and tried and tried to find her other son, but everyone was saying, you figure you've seen Juan, you've seen them all.
You guys are a pretty dry audience. You better get back in the canoe. Somebody asked me if I had any good jokes, and I told them no, just all bad ones. Now, here's one for you. Now, they got to listen pretty carefully. Johnny's mother had three sons. The first one was named Nickel. The second one was named Dime. What was the name of the third son? Did you get it? You didn't get it. Okay, now listen carefully. Johnny's mother had three sons. First one was named Nickel. The second one was named Dime. What was the name of the third son? Johnny. Johnny's mother. Okay, you weren't listening, were you?
I wear many hats as I walk around. This request was made to tell a joke. What do you call an Indian with no lips? Pointless.
Now that's my kind of humor. I'd like to get all the drummers and singers and dancers and everybody come out in the middle of the floor with me. We're going to do another song, I think.
Snoqualmie, Snohomish, let's hear it for them one more time.
Okay, we want to ask permission to leave your shores. We want to be able to untie our canoes. So on behalf of the Blue Heron Canoe, do we have permission for us to untie the canoe? Doesn't mean we're leaving. We're staying till the end.
On behalf of Squaxin Island Tribe, we want to thank you for being here, considering the jokes aside. Thank you for all the great songs, the great wisdom that you brought here, all the power and strength that you brought into the canoe families that are here tonight, and give you permission to leave. Thank you. After it's all over. Thank you very much.
We too, Snoqualmie, enjoy your feast, festivities, and songs and dances, and we too ask permission to leave your shores, but we're staying to the end too.
On behalf of Squaxin Island Tribe, we thank you also for all the songs and the wisdom that you brought to the tribe and to the rest of the canoe family that are still here, and we give you permission to leave. Aho!
We'll do two songs. We'll leave on the second one. First, the next to the last song is a prayer song by the Snoqualmie.
This is a prayer song. It's a Snoqualmie prayer song. We would like to ask, please, no recordings of this song. We would also like to ask if you would please stand.
Oh,
Snoqualmie and Snohomish, thank you.